For MC flexion, you have your patient's hand in a flat position on a solid surface or a table, shown here. First thing you will have your patient do is perform a full MC flexion while keeping these two joints straight. So go ahead and do that for me, Rach. Okay, and then come back down. Now, because she was able to do this, we know that she's at least a 3. Now, Rachel, I want you to come about halfway, and I will apply resistance at the proximal phalanx, and I will stabilize the desired metacarpal. So in this case, it will be the second. So resist me, Rachel, 3, 2, 1. Resist me, 3, 2, 1. Notice I'm doing it to all of the digits in her hand, 3, 2, 1, just like that. Now, if she was not able to perform flexion of the MC joint, then we can have her in a gravity eliminated position as shown here, but I mean, how much does a finger weigh? So I will leave that up to your discretion. If they're not able to flex the MC joint at all, then you can palpate for the lumbricals. And they are just proximal, you can palpate them deep, just proximal to the MC joint here. If you feel these muscles firing, that will be a 1, and if you do not feel them firing, that will be a 0. Testing MC joint extension. Patient's palm will be on the table with fingers hanging off the table, as shown here. Rachel, I'd like you to perform a bear claw with your fingertips and extension here at the MC joint. Very good. Because she's able to perform this, we know that that is at least a grade 3. Go ahead and go about halfway again with that, with the bear claw again, Rachel. Okay, I'm going to stabilize the metacarpals, all 4 of them, and then I'm going to apply resistance on all 4 proximal phalanxes at the same time. So go ahead and resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1. Depending on the resistance she gives me, I will grade her as either a 4 or a 5. Testing MC extension, gravity minimized position. You'll have your patient's forearm resting on the table as well as the medial aspect of her hand. Rachel, what I want you to do is I want you to slightly ball up your fist for me and then extend it outward, but keep your fingers in a claw-like position. Very good. Because she was able to perform this in a gravity minimized position, that would be a grade 2. If she was not able to perform this motion, I would come up here and I would palpate for the extensor digitorum. If I feel the muscle firing, that is a grade 1. And if I do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0. Testing PIP flexion, you'll have your patient's hand once again on a flat surface or table as shown here. First thing you'll have your patient do is perform a full range of motion of the PIP joint. You will do this by have the patient bring their hand into a fist while keeping their DIP into extension. So go ahead and do that for me, Rachel. And now come back down. Because she was able to do this, we know she's at least a 3 at this joint. Now, I am going to test PIP flexion by performing each test on the each individual fingers. So for the first one, I will do it on. I will apply resistance on the middle phalanx, and then stabilize the proximal phalanx. So Rachel, yeah, come up with that, and I will resist. Resist me, 3, 2, 1. Middle finger, 3, 2, 1. Ring finger, 3, 2, 1, and pinky, 3, 2, 1. Now, if she was not able to perform range of motion while in this position, you can have her in gravity eliminated position, which is shown here. If she is able to perform that, that was going to be a 2. And if you do not see any range of motion, you can test for the flexor digitorum superficialis, which is found here at the proximal phalanx. If you feel and it's just the tendon in here, but if you feel it firing or sliding, you'll kind of feel it sliding. If you feel it sliding, that will be a grade 1, and if you do not feel any movement there, that will be a grade 0. Testing DIP flexion, you'll have your patient's hand on a flat surface or a table as shown here. First thing you'll have your patient do is perform a bear claw with her fingers. Because she's able to perform this full range of motion, that is a grade 3. To test for a grade 4 or 5, I will stabilize the PIP and the MC joints by making sure they don't move and only the DIP joint can move. So go about halfway with this DIP. I'm going to apply resistance. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. And at the pinky, 3, 2, 1. Let me stabilize that better. 3, 2, 1. If she's not able to perform any range of motion in this position with the DIP joints, I can have her in a gravity-limited position as shown here. If, you know, the DIP joint is a small joint though, so to test for a 2 in this position, I'll just leave that up to you. It's just not a lot of weight. If you do not see any range of motion happening at the DIP joint in this position, you can palpate for the flexor digitorum profundus at the middle phalanx, right here. If you feel that muscle firing, that is a grade 1, and if you do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0. Testing MC Abduction, patient's hand will be on a flat surface or table as shown here. The first thing you'll have your patient do is perform full abduction of all of her MC joints. So go ahead and spread those fingers out for me, Rach. There you go. Now, because she was able to do this, we know that she is at least a grade 3. Also, keep in mind that the third digit goes ulnarly and radially into abduction. So we will be testing it going both ways. So go about halfway with those digits for me, Rach. There we go. So if we were to test the second digit abduction, MC abduction, I will stabilize the desired metacarpal and I will apply resistance on the radial side of the second digit and I will be forcing it into adduction. So go ahead and resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1. And then for the middle finger, I will stabilize and then radial. 3, 2, 1. Ulnar side, because it's both sides, 3, 2, 1. Ring finger, on the ulnar side, 3, 2, 1. And then pinky ulnar side, 3, 2, 1. Now, if she was not able to perform any range of motion in this position, I would palpate the dorsal interossei, which is found between the metacarpals. So there is a dorsal interossei here, 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 and here. If I feel those muscles firing, that is a grade 1, and if I do not feel them firing, that is a grade 0. Testing MC Adduction. Patient's hand will start in Abduction. Go ahead, Rachel, I want you to perform full adduction for me. Because she was able to do this, we know she's at least a grade 3. Go move that out about halfway for me, Rach. Now, when I am testing for adduction, I will once again stabilize the desired metacarpal and I will apply resistance on the radial side of the fifth digit, forcing it into abduction. So resist me 3, 2, 1, and then I will go to the fourth digit once again on the radial side, 3, 2, 1. Make sure that you're on the proximal phalanx and not up here. And then I will go to the second digit and I will apply on the ulnar side of the proximal phalanx. Resist me 3, 2, 1. Now notice that I did not apply any resistance on the third digit as it only performs abduction and not adduction. Now if you do not see any movement going on at these digits into adduction, you will want to palpate the palmar interossei, but this muscle is very deep inside the palm. So instead, how we grade for this is seeing how much movement is, as we can see at the digits. If you see any movement whatsoever, that is a grade 1. And if you do not see any movement, that is a grade 0.